8. Listening to that is Zach Polanski, who is a Green Party politician and an activist with Extinction Rebellion. Were you protesting over the last week or so, Mr. Polanski? Good morning.
Good morning. I have been protesting, and as your senior constable or former senior constable just said, this is fundamental to our human way of life. He then went on to say, equally, we have a set of circumstances at the moment which make it difficult. Well, if it's fundamental to our human way of life, let's not start eroding that proud British tradition of protest.
So is the ability to get to hospital if you're sick, but it would seem some of your colleagues prohibited that last week.
Well, actually, it was inaccurate what he was saying. The hospital blockade was actually blocked off by the police because they were trying to prevent access to a bridge because they didn't want more people to protest.
No, it wasn't. We had.
I can assure you, Nick, that no one from the Extinction Rebellion has been blocking hospitals.
I can assure you that our reporter witnessed an ambulance performing a U-turn as they came to some of, I don't know whether you were there, but some of your colleagues or fellow protesters.
The reporter witnessed that. In line with what I just said, Nick, the U-turn happened because the police made a blockade. But anyway, the point is...
No, Mr. Polanski, I'm so sorry. The police wouldn't have needed to do anything. The ambulance wouldn't have needed to do a U-turn if you didn't close down bridges.
I think it's important to look at why we're closing down the bridges.
No, I think it's important to get someone to hospital who's dying, don't you?
Absolutely, it's crucial, which is why we're not blocking hospitals. Why possibly would someone protesting against a climate emergency block a hospital?
Because you closed a bridge.
Something that's happened.
Because you closed a bridge.
Exactly. So the police need to find different ways to deal with closing bridges that don't involve them blocking off hospitals and not letting
people
through.
If you close a bridge, how is an ambulance going to get across if you and your colleagues are on the bridge?
Because Extinction Rebellion always let ambulances through. In this particular case, and I've seen the case online, the ambulance wasn't let through by the police blockade because they didn't want people joining the protesters. The protesters would have let the ambulance through. We always let a lane clear for emergency vehicles.
How kind of you. Were you supportive of the measures taken against publishing presses up and down the country?
Yes, absolutely I was. I think for Priti Patel to call it criminality is kind of rich when just today the government are in trouble themselves for crimes,
which they say
they committed in a specific and limited way. Specific and limited action against Murdoch's press.
It wasn't just Mr. Murdoch's press, was it? You also stopped distribution of the Daily Mail and the Daily Telegraph. What gives you and your colleagues the right to stop a free press?
What gives everyone the right, and not just me and my colleagues, but anyone at all, is to call for a free press. It's laughable to say we have a free press in this country. There's nothing free about Murdoch's empire.
Right. I'll try again. I don't know what you don't understand. Neither the Daily Telegraph or the Daily Mail are published by Mr. Murdoch. Okay? So you manage to block... People who like to pick up a paper on a Saturday or a Sunday, whether it's one of Mr. Murdoch's titles or not, were prohibited from doing that. In one instance, as you're probably aware, reading an article by Sir David Attenborough on the very cause that you espouse. But you stopped that getting out to the readers. I say again, what gives you the right to do that?
Well, I think most people who wanted to read it have read it by now. We also have an online press. But also, five people control 70% of the UK's media. Now, that's not just Rupert Murdoch,
you accept... OK, you are probably aware that one of the philanthropists who helps back Extinction Rebellion is now considering withdrawing his backing.
I think if people want to withdraw their backing because they're unhappy about corporate kind of strongholds over organisations, that's exactly the sort of money we shouldn't be taking anyway, because that's the sort of money that the Conservative Party Labour Party are taking.
So this is a philanthropist by the name of Trevor Nielsen, who says a free press is the cornerstone of democracy. I imagine we would not provide them funding again. So he's wrong also, is he, Mr. Polanski?
I think he is wrong, yes. A free press is a cornerstone of democracy. Sadly, we neither have a free press in this country nor a democracy.
And veteran campaigner Bianca Jagger, who's also condemned you and your colleagues' activities at these print works, she's wrong as well, is she?
I think she's wrong, and that's okay. We're free to have a disagreement.
No, but we're not free, are we, in your world? Because we're not free to get newspapers. Well, we can only really have the debate that you allow.
No, I think, I've come on LBC, and clearly you don't agree with me. I'm very happy to have this disagreement right now.
But why can't you let newspapers be committed in a fair and equitable way. Right, but why can't you let newspapers go out and explore that debate and put different cases and sides of it as well? Why stop newspapers? That's the sort of thing they do in countries such as North Korea and Russia.
Nick, I think you're painting the argument that the newspapers were stopped permanently and no one ever read a paper again.
No.
It was a few hours of disruption from a particular propaganda newspaper and a couple of others too to make a point about the climate emergency because we're facing an existential threat to our planet and we need the media to tell the truth. So one of the things we did was disrupt the media for a few hours so we could have conversations like this one about why the media not telling the truth. And that's partly because of corporate sponsorship.
Well, how can they tell the truth? They're going to get their papers out there. Do you think you're a criminal?
I don't think I'm a criminal at all. I think you just had Matt Hancock on, the Secretary of State.
Yes.
And I think what the government are doing is particularly criminal at the moment, whether it's around the pandemic, whether it's about the way they're treating protesters, or the way that they're breaking international law over Brexit.
Oh, your last point is well made. I think they are in a world of pain over that. But how do they break the law as regards the way they treat protesters, lastly, Mr. Polanski?
The police found that themselves. They had to withdraw some of the arrests from the last rebellion because they were found unlawful. I think, for instance, giving bail conditions to people that they can't be anywhere within the M25 when they committed a crime, in quotation marks, that wasn't even within London. You start to go, OK, you are stretching the boundaries of the law here, which is why they're trying to get the law changed, because they know they're not within it.
Grateful for your time, Zach Polanski. You're a politician with the Green Party. You're an activist with Extinction Rebellion. Let's see what others...